Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to another Minecraft tutorial with me, Jeracraft, and today I'm going to be showing you how to build a small detailed house. I previewed it about 2 weeks ago and many of you guys have been requesting this video, so let's go ahead and give it a go. So first of all, you need to start off by building the base of the house, so copy out this layout of stone bricks and fill in the gap with half slabs of oak wood. Then go ahead and place these full blocks of cobblestone. The top corners have a one block gap because that's where the fireplace is going to go. We need to go ahead and mark where the entrance and windows are going to be. So for the entrance, we're going to grab half slabs of stone and it's going to go 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's the entrance. We're going to have one window on this side, leaving a one block gap. One window here, and finally the last window here. For this corner, that's where the fountain's going to be. If you've seen the preview video, you should know what I'm talking about. And we're going to have stone brick here and here, and then we're going to have a two block gap on this side and a one block gap on this side. And then join it off with a full block of cobblestone. So copy this now. Now we need to fill in the gaps with stairs, so we're going to have oak wood for the porch, oak wood for the windows. Where the actual window is going to be, we're going to have stone brick stairs. Same goes for all the other sides. So oak wood, stone brick, oak wood, stone brick, and oak wood. For the well, we're going to have upside down cobblestone stairs to fill in these gaps. And here is where the fireplace is going to go, so we're going to extend it an extra block further away. We're going to have stone bricks here, bring it all the way along until it meets the other block, and we're going to add another corner block of stone bricks. Now the following cobblestone is going to be raised a further 3 blocks, so 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3. Same goes for all the cobblestone blocks at the front. So that's a total of 7 pillars, and for this final gap over here we're just going to fill it in with oak wood stairs. And now we're going to raise the initial house, and it's going to be an extra 3 blocks of oak wood all the way around this layout. So now that we've raised the walls, we're going to create archways for all the cobblestone pillars. So the ones in the middle are going to have one extended block, and the ones in the corner are going to have two extended blocks. And that's going to be the same all the way around. So you should get this. That's 2 single pillars and 5 corners. And now we're going to extend the pillars with upside down cobblestone stairs, just like that. And that's going to be the same all the way around. Going back to where the fireplace stands, we're just going to extend these corners an extra block. So stone brick here and here, and then just raise with oak wood, and that should fill in the unnecessary gaps. Then we're going to go back to our oak wood stairs and just create the same archways as we did with the cobblestone, just one block further in. And that's going to go where the windows and doors are going to be, so let's do that now. For the corner, we're going to have the pond. You need to go with a row of oak wood full blocks, just like this, and then raise it with fence until it reaches the top of the wall. Now where we have our grass, we're going to replace with mossy cobblestone or stone bricks, whatever you prefer. And then we're going to fill up the gap with water. So just bring it all the way. And then you can add some lily pads. And to finish off, grab cobblestone wall, place 2 on the corner, followed by a full block on top, a and then join up the archways with half slabs of cobblestone. For the actual fireplace, we're going to remove the back wall that we had of oak wood, then replace all the grass blocks with cobblestone. The actual fireplace will go here, so that's where the netherrack's going to be. And so that the wood doesn't actually catch fire, we need to grab some stone bricks and go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, same on the other side. So 3 blocks raised all the way to the top of the wall. And that's going to stop the actual wood from catching fire. We need to fill in this gap with 2 blocks of cobblestone. So bring it all the way across, go back to our cobblestone wall, and we're going to place 2 on either side of the fireplace. We might as well do this for the windows, so 2 blocks of cobblestone wall on either side, punch out the window, same for the door, cobblestone wall, door's going to go there, same for this window. And for this last window, we're actually going to have 1 block, because the actual physics of the house doesn't allow you to have a 2 block raised window. So now you need to go ahead and add the windows and the door, as well as a full block of stone brick atop of all the cobblestone pillars. And now we're going to add a redstone lamp here for the front porch, and come along the top with half slabs of oak wood. As for the window, we're going to add upside down stone brick stairs, and then same again with the half slabs of oak. This window is going to be exactly the same as this window, it's already been done. And here we're going to add redstone lamp, and then the oak wood. Then for the very very small window way over here, we're just going to add full blocks of stone bricks, upside down stone stairs for the middle, then we're going to remove these upside down stairs, cross over with half slabs, fill in this gap, half slabs again, and half slabs again. And there you have it. For the actual front garden, I added 5 blocks of cobblestone wall extended from either pillars, then added the gate as well as a path of half slabs, and then some bone meal to add some grass. Just before we move on, we need to come over here to the well and just remove a layer of fence, because my bad, I made a mistake. Just remove an entire layer and replace it with full blocks of oak wood. There we go. Right guys, so now back to the fireplace to finish off the first floor. Then we can move on to the roof, where we actually have the second floor. So first of all, we need to replace these cobblestone stairs as well as the full blocks. Then we're going to grab cobblestone stairs, place them in the middle, and stone stairs for the sides. We're going to bring full blocks across following the same pattern, and then the same with half slabs. As you can see, and that should be the first floor complete. So guys, now coming up to the roof, things can get rather complicated, so you're gonna have to bear with me and just basically copy what I do, because I don't know exactly how I built this roof, because you know it's quite difficult to replicate something that you've already built, but I'll use this as reference and we'll see how that goes from there. What I'm gonna do is just do a basic outline of the roof and then just use that as a guideline to finish it off. So just copy what I do, starting us from now. Right guys, I'm sure you're able to follow that easily. As long as you copy what I do, you shouldn't have a problem whatsoever. We're just going to finish off the outline by adding upside down jungle wood stairs over here, and then joining up with oak wood slabs, just like we've been doing. Now if you notice, we have these half slab gaps over here, and we're just going to cover it up with oak wood. So just bring it along, and I really do like the texture that it gives, just all the way across, and it does give a nice finishing touch, just an extra detail to the build. To finish off the outline, we're going to raise the roof and make space for the windows and the balcony. So again, you're going to have to copy me and do as follows. So now we can go ahead and fill in these gaps. So upside down jungle stairs on top, and then a full block in the middle. So go ahead and copy what I do now. So now that we have the archways as guidance, it shouldn't be too complicated. All we have to do is join them up following the same pattern. So over here we're going to have jungle woods half slabs, and then that's going to come across with jungle wood stairs till it meets with the other archway. And then all you have to do is follow the pattern along until it meets up with this archway. Same goes for this side over here, so jungle wood stairs all the way across until it meets this archway, and this archway will join up this one. So let's go ahead and finish this off. So basically all I've done is grabbed some jungle wood stairs to join up the parts of the roof that actually join up correctly. So for example, over here, I haven't continued the flow of the jungle wood stairs because it's not going to join up appropriately. And that's because it's going to extend all the way along until it meets up with this corner piece here. And that's going to come across a further two blocks, and that's what's going to create the overhang that we have on top of the archway. So hard to explain this, but things can get rather complicated. So all we have to do now is extend this archway all the way across until it meets this one. So you basically get the idea of how I've actually joined up the roof, and if you have any trouble whatsoever, you can always leave a comment below and I'll help you out as best as I can. All we have to do now is just add in the upside down jungle wood stairs to these corner pieces. Just one block should be fine. And also, if we come all the way across to this side, we need to extend this archway a further two blocks in. So it's going to be one and two. Don't need these, by the way. We can have full blocks extended as well. We'll just finish off this archway. So now that archway has been extended a further two blocks in. Now we can grab some upside down jungle wood stairs and just place them on the top of these archways to create this overhang. It's going to be the same for all of them except for the chimney piece. We're going to grab some jungle wood half slabs and that's going to be extended an extra block. And now we're going to go back to our stone brick stairs and we're going to place them on top of these overhangs that we've just created, including the actual chimney piece. And then finally, there we have it. Oh, there's one more over here. And basically what you have to do now is join them up with half slabs of stone. So that's going to come across. This one's going to be placed three blocks. One, two, and three. One, two. Can't quite reach that one. One, two, three, and four. And for this section of roof here, what we need to do is just grab some jungle wood stairs, two blocks over here, and then a full block or half block over here, just to finish off that roof. There we go, and basically what I did is just exchange the jungle wood stairs for, you know, the stone brick stairs. So basically, going to the chimney piece over here, you can just break off these sections of roof and just exchange them until it meets up with the top section. I like the effect, but the only problem is that on this side we only have one, so when you actually join it up, it's going to look a bit awkward, but it's not much of a problem. It does look nice at the end, so you can go ahead and add that effect later on. What we're going to do now is add in the windows and the actual decoration. So to actually get started on the windows, we need to make some changes on the inside. So let's make our way in, and basically what we have is this really weird corner right here. What you need to do is remove 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. And then grab some full blocks of jungle wood, just make a pillar to cover this up, and that should be right. What we need to do now is grab some oak wood planks and just fill in these gaps. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and 1. Same for this side, we're just going to start from here and bring it all the way across until you basically cover up all the sections of light. You might need to put some torches if you want to avoid getting bats. And just come all the way to the top. The doorway is going to go here. So that's your entrance to the balcony. And for this bit here, we can cover it up with jungle wood. And that can come all the way across, so we don't get any gaps. Same on this side, jungle wood. And nope, that could go back where it was. Then over here, jungle wood again. And it's going to go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. We need to add one stone brick slab over here. And then 1, 2, 3, 4. That's going to go jungle wood as well. Sorry, oak wood. And then 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So if you were able to follow what I've just done, one extra block here. Everything should look like this. So we're going to add in the windows now, so let's go outside. And we're going to grab glass. One window here. Another window here. Glass right here. This is where the chimney is going to go, so we don't need anything there. And that's the balcony. So everything's starting to look nice now. What I did was basically grab some flower pots and added a front sort of ledge. Some flowers. Do the same on this side. Didn't add any there because it blocks the view, obviously. Right guys, so that was probably the most complicated part of the tutorial. So I'd be really grateful if you leave a comment below and let me know if you were able to follow it. Just before we move on to the chimney, what we're going to do is add in an extra window right here, because I thought the roof looked rather plain. So basically we're going to cut out 5 blocks of stairs. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So starting from this corner piece all the way across 5 blocks. Then we're going to add stairs here and stairs here. You can extend these outwards, and then we can grab some oak wood, fill in the gap, go back to our oak wood slabs, and then bring it across. So then we can go ahead and build the archway the same way we've done the others. We're going to have 2 blocks of stacked stairs, and then basically join it up to the roof. So upside down stairs. We're going to have actually 1 block on the front only, and then just remove all these back parts so the actual roof joins up to the archway. Then we're going to have stairs again and the full block, and that should join up perfectly with the rest of the roof. Then the upside down stairs on the front. And we can do the same thing with the stone bricks. Half slabs come all the way across, and then stone brick stairs, just like that. Then all you need to do is add the oak woods, punch out a gap for the window, and add your flower pots on the front. Right guys, so some final details before we move on to the chimney. It's been quite a long tutorial, so let's finish off. First up, we need a balcony door, as well as some jungle wood stairs to fill in the gaps. Remove these 2 blocks, add a redstone torch here, and a redstone lamp to give the balcony some light. Then if we move over to the pond, we're going to go over to the corner, remove this block, add another redstone torch, followed by a redstone lamp. So now that adds some extra light to the building. And now we can finally finish off with the chimney. So first of all, we're going to remove these 2 jungle blocks and replace them with stone bricks. Bring it all the way up until it meets the top. Then we're going to grab stone stairs, full blocks, stone stairs again, except upside down. Fill in this gap with cobblestone. And then coming up to the roof, we're going to have this removed. Add some full blocks, cobblestone wall, stone brick stairs. Follow the same pattern. And then finally you can finish off by adding some smoke. People use cobweb, it's not my idea obviously. I don't particularly like the cobweb idea, but it's the closest thing you have to smoke. And it gives it a nice added effect. Right guys, so that is the end of the detailed house tutorial. In part 2 I will be doing the interior of the house. It's been quite a long tutorial and definitely a lot of hard work with the video rendering and the copying out of a house that I've already built, but I mean, it's all been worth it in the end, and I would be really grateful if obviously you leave a like, a comment, maybe even subscribe to my channel and check out some of my latest videos. And guys, one more thing, if you remember the time-lapse video that I did on the server some time ago, the actual server admins are looking for new builders, so that gives you the opportunity to start something new as well as the builder rank on a server. Obviously you need to be above a certain age and build in a certain style, and obviously respect the server rules. So if you want more information, I'll put up a link in the description where you can contact the server admin by his channel and apply. So guys, anyways, thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.